Hey guys, Zealot here. Welcome to another video. Today we're going to do something a bit more different. I felt like ranting and criticizing something. So, here we are. So, today we are doing, I don't know, a sequel? I don't freaking know, but we're talking about Fortnite today and why I don't like it. By the way, this music in the background, though, like, whew. Oh man, I'm just listening to it, man. It's just, I'm really vibing with it. I can't hear it. I'm recording. Yup. Maybe I should add music in the background more often. I don't know. Do you like it? Do you not? Whatever. I don't care. I'm doing it anyway. So I have a lot of things written down. So buckle up, and something that a YouTuber would say before a long video, and let's get started. By the way, yes, I was tortured. I tortured myself and actually played the game for gameplay. Yeah. So, starting our Fortnite analysis, is your Battle Royale typical game? For my experience, you just land and, you know, you either die right off the bat or maybe you escape, maybe you land at a place that nobody's been to. It just all depends. But the thing that I've discovered is you either just land and die immediately, or you land and you survive to like mid-game. And also there are the AI-controlled areas, I don't know what they're called, the heist thingies that are like now Marvel-themed or something. Yeah. Okay, so if you land at those, sometimes you'll just, like, for really cautious people, you'll disguise, like, in one of the phone booth, you'll loot up, and nobody ever does that anymore. Everybody just kills all the AI, no problem. Because people have discovered that they're a body, and why would you disguise if you can just blast them in the face with a... So after that, you know, you're done looting, you got a nice loadout, you just see no one. Like, I don't know why this always happens in a game. You see no one, and you just continue to go like to the next storm cycle, and a couple of storm cycles later you might see somebody, you know. And at the very end, if you get to end game, like top 10, you either just die or win. Like, it just depends if they're sweaty or not, really, from my experience. So from that typical game, you're like, well, Seth, you just described the Battle Royale game. Well, viewer, you're right, I did describe a Battle Royale game, you know. But there's a lot more things that go into a game of Fortnite that I don't vibe with it, alright? I don't like it. Now, first of all, there's a ton of just useless items and things that nobody uses, like fishing, you know? Fishing, like, if you find a fishing spot, maybe you'll fish it out quick, right? But if you're just fishing normally, or if you find a fishing rod in the house, you're not gonna pick that up. You're not gonna sacrifice an inventory slot, you know? That's just one example. We'll get into more here. Now, with the fight scenarios, your typical fight scenario from my experience, somebody gets shot at, you know, maybe you'll take a bit of damage, maybe you won't, maybe they're bad at aiming, maybe, you know, you're getting sniped at, you know. The first thing anybody does, the community has adapted to this, alright, they immediately just build everything. And they never build out any, you know, materials or actually try to strategize or anything. They just build either willy-nilly. Maybe they'll build a nice tower or something. They just get some kind of cover in between you and the enemy. Which makes sense, right? But not when you're freaking cranking on them, trying to get high ground, just sweating all over them, encasing them, and then blasting them in the face with a 12-gauge shotgun! Seriously, And you just build cover, you try to get higher ground, or if you're already on higher ground, you're just gonna defend yourself if you're not on the high ground. And if you're in a build battle with somebody, or quote-unquote build battles, which I hate build battles, probably because I'm bad at them, but the main goal for me, what I think of as a build battle, you're just trying to trap, you're trying to encase somebody, you're trying to get over them, and then get on their level, blast them with a 12-gauge shotgun, and then, you know, if they don't die right away, you just keep building random stuff, you keep trying to get higher and higher on them. And in my opinion, it's just stupid. You know, I'm gonna put it out there right now. Fortnite was never intended. Like, their building was never intended to be just this really, really fast-paced mechanic. But now that it is, and that's how people use it, they're not gonna take it out. They're not gonna nerf it. What, they're gonna make a cooldown from when you need to build? You know, when you build one structure, you gotta wait 5 seconds to build another, you know? They're not gonna do that because their entire player base is just based on this really quick, fast-paced building. Get something in between me and the enemy. Get high ground. It's just how the fights work in that game, right? It's always about whoever has the positional advantage or is quote-unquote better at building. Right now in the modern age of Fortnite, it's not about aim. It's not about how good you are. It's just how good you can build. It's whoever's quote-unquote better at building that always wins. It's just that simple. Either that or you get sniped in the head. You know, either way. And also, the Fortnite community likes to rush. They like to storm in. Like, they like to push. And the weird thing is, almost every single fight that I've been in, almost every single fight that I've seen, always ends when somebody pushes up. Either you're in a nice mid-range fight, but then they get bored and they're like, oh, let's bum rush them, you know? Every fight in Fortnite always ends when somebody tries to go on the offensive, tries to push their position, and then either the people that they're pushing are low health, either they're healing, either they're busy reviving a teammate or something, and then they'll just bum rush them, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but it always ends when somebody pushes up. You know, in PUBG, my go-to battle royale, it's always about the long range and mid-range engagements. It's never about close range. That's why nobody uses shotguns. Nobody uses submachine guns. So some of them, like the UMP's pretty good in that game, right? Nice mid-range. But that also brings us to a point that I'll talk about later. Now, continuing on with the building idea, literally everyone uses wood. I am, like, the only time you're going to use brick or metal, if you're not upgrading your gun, you're going to be, nobody ever uses anything. Like, they always use wood. Wood is the most common. Wood has a nice amount of health. Why use anything else when you can just use wood, right? Whenever you're using another material, it's because you're low on wood almost every time. Again, Fortnite's quote-unquote skill is determined solely by who is the better builder. Not aim, not strategy, just rush in, die, queue up your next game. Now recently added, vehicles. Vehicles in Fortnite have always been a problem, kind of. Vehicles are not really necessary because the map is typically smaller than typical Battle Royales, right? So your sprint speed is a nice, constant moving speed, and there's not like a speed boost or anything like Fortnite, besides friggin' chili peppers, I don't know what those things are, but... And fuel, you'll need to fuel your car, right? And it might seem when you're driving your car like you gotta keep your fuel, you gotta savor it, you know? You don't got much of this stuff, it doesn't grow on trees, but it's so abundant. It might not seem like it in-game, because like to me... Like, whenever I run out of fuel, like, I feel like I'm done. Like, I gotta ditch the car. But then, like, you know, two houses of looting later, and I'll already have more gas, you know? And also, you're telling me, Epic Games, you know, they seem pretty smart. They seem like nice businessmen. You know, they seem pretty intellectual. But they're not intellectual enough to think that boats and helicopters don't have a fuel. Like, they don't take fuel. Boats and helicopters have infinite amounts of fuel for some dumb reason. And also, I don't know where else to put this. I can't believe, you know, this is a while ago. And I don't see enough people talking about this, right? So DC and Fortnite did this, like, collab, right? Where they made a Batman and a Catwoman skin, right? That's fine. Except it's a shooter game! Batman, The Dark Knight. The one that never ever uses guns. When you think of somebody that's anti-gun, you think of Batman. Or a bunch of Karens, or Joe Biden, or... Yeah, but... You think of Batman. I do. I think of Batman anytime I think about somebody that doesn't need guns. And guess what? You got Batman over here slinging 5.56 at people's skulls in this cartoony world. Like, I don't care if Catwoman has a gun, but Batman, you really had to do it to him. He broke his number one rule. Well, technically, according to Save the World, they don't die. Like, they get sent to the, like, they get medical attention. It's kind of like GTA, where they don't actually die. But still, you got Batman with an AR-15 in his hands, you know, slinging 9mm at people. Not with the AR-15, I'm not that stupid. And also, Stormtrooper skins, they look pretty sick, right? But I'm pretty sure they don't teach Stormtroopers how to, you know, shoot M4A1s. Or, you know, I don't know how they just instantly know. They have superb firearm skill. You know, it's just, they're natural. They already know. They already know how to do it. And also all the other Star Wars characters, Rey, Finn, you know them. Same thing with them. My next point I'm going to bring up is the player base. Now, a lot of people say, hey, Fortnite is a fine game. Like, it's fine. It's nice for friends. It's free so everybody can play it. They're like, all the people that tell me, they're like, oh, it's just the player base. The player base is toxic, right? That's why the game is bad. I don't really think that's why the game is bad. Like, in my personal opinion, that's not why it's bad. But yes, it is a valid point. So here, everyone in Fortnite likes rushing. They are always they push up, get as close to the enemy as possible, try to blast them with a 12-gauge shotgun, right? Sure, it's a strategy, but literally everyone does it, so it's just expected at that point. Now, this goes for many other Battle Royale games too, but when you're downed, like, you will almost always get finished. Like, yay, I just blasted a defenseless person for no reason with a 12-gauge shotgun. Am I a pro player yet? No, you are not. You are an absolute buffoon. You could have used that same 12-gauge shell to shoot another person that's about to kill you. And you would still get credit for that kill that person that you downed, too. Like, come on, guys. This is also a huge problem in Apex, like, because I don't even know why I take pity on people anymore. Like, whenever I down somebody, I give them, like, at least 30 seconds for their teammates to come. That's at the very least. If I'm feeling, like, mad at them, or if they just disrespected me, then I'll blast them. But, like, come on. If they deserve it, sure, I'll do it. But, man, it just sucks when you get instantly finished. Like, what's even the point of downing when you're just gonna die right away, you know? And some might say, oh, it's because you can respawn, and, you know, like, they can respawn anyway. No, that's also a point that I didn't even write down. The reboot vans, they're not abundant, not as abundant as Apex. Like, when you see a reboot van, like, that's, it's most of the time, for me anyway, it's outside the circle. It's too far away. You gotta go, like, you got 3 squad mates reboot cards on your back, bro. You clutched it. Now you gotta, like, hike it all the way into the circle. And then you're probably gonna die by then, by another squad, just to get your teammates back. And I don't like that. Next point. Oh, yeah, and this is kind of just a nitpick. But the stupid emotes, man. Like, the music and everything with the lyrics now. Like, okay, I absolutely hate the freaking Rolly Rolly song in the emote. It's just stupid, alright? And it's funny, because Fortnite is literally encouraging toxicity with some of these emotes, too. Like, they're just, it's dumb, because, you know, they made it for when you down somebody and you want to flex on them, that your quote-unquote building skills that beat them, you know? I'm so much better than you. Haha, emote on you and then blast you with a 12-gauge. You know, that's just gonna be a theme this video. You get blasted by 12-gauge shotguns. Yeah, it's an overused joke. If it's even a joke. Anyway, Nintendo Switch and mobile players are in the same lobbies as PC, Xbox, and PlayStation. That's just dumb. Alright, maybe they have a controller, like a Bluetooth controller connected to their phone. You know, maybe they're using the Pro Controller instead of the Joy-Cons. But if you got somebody tippity-tapping on their screen to trying to crank 90s, or if you got a person with Joy-Cons, you know, trying to, you know, win a Fortnite game. By the way, I hate the Joy-Cons on Switch. They're way too clicky and tiny in my hands. But it's just unfair. Like, if you have a keyboard and mouse, if you have a controller, like a PlayStation controller, Xbox controller, you're gonna be the person who's tippity tapping on their screen. I don't care if they have auto fire or anything. You're gonna win. Now, this is where I'm gonna get heated. I'm a little bit of a gun nerd, alright? So, my next big point on page 3 of this tirade is the weapons in Fortnite. Alright, first of all, the weapons are doomed to their ranges. You know, you got the close range, the medium range, and the long range. Typical for video games. You know, you got your close, mid, and long range, right? Makes sense in theory. But the thing with close range is, you got your shotguns and your submachine guns, and for some reason, handguns. Those should be mid-range, but you got, you know, your shotgun. It makes sense. It's for balancing. If it were like real life, they would be mid-range, and that's just not good for balancing. That's why a lot of games have, you know, close range shotguns. It makes sense. However, submachine guns, there's PUBG, which has way different pacing, you know, but still it has mid-range submachine guns for the most part. Maybe there's exceptions like the micro Uzi, stuff like that. Just the vector is mostly close range, but come on, Fortnite, you got an MP5, alright, that's a cool SMG, and, you know, it's just not, like, if you're seeing somebody from mid to long range with an SMG, you're not going to use it. You are going to rely heavily on each and every game of Fortnite. You're always going to have the same loadout. You're going to have a shotgun and an AR, sometimes an SMG, most of the time an SMG for me. But that's it. It's always the same loadout. In PUBG, I have to rely on what I find. I have to rely on what can take more attachments. I have to rely on what I have more ammo for. There's so much that goes into what I choose with my weapons in PUBG. However, Fortnite and even Apex kind of falls victim to this. You're always using the same guns. Alright? Always. You're always going to find the same guns. An assault rifle, a shotgun, it doesn't matter, maybe you prefer the charged shotgun, maybe you prefer the pump, I don't care, you're always going to be using a shotgun. And also, the awful, awful bullet drop system with sniper rifles, zero bullet drop on other weapons. You're telling me, a 5.56 assault rifle can shoot further than a sniper rifle? I don't know how much it really shoots, it just depends. But come on, the sniper should actually, like, not drop like a friggin' rock. It makes sense. It's for balancing. But if it is for balancing, put bullet drop on your other guns. Ugh, it's stupid. Also, ARs, assault rifles, like I said, are an absolute necessity in this game. They are so reliable, so nice in so many different situations. But the burst assault rifle, I actually preferred this gun way back, like, when I actually played Fortnite, I preferred the burst over the full auto assault rifle. It was a nice alternative, it fit my playstyle more, and I just liked it more. Now, they have nerfed it into oblivion, and now it has 20 round magazines, which, why? I mean, okay, but they act like it's better. You know, they act like people actually prefer burst over assault rifles. That was just me, like no one else does, you know. It's just little old Seth here with his burst. Oh, you want to have that full auto? But now it only does 2-round bursts. I kind of understand the 20-round mags, but 2-round bursts on a rifle? Come on, you're better than that Fortnite. I know you have the stupidest gun mechanics ever, but 2-round bursts on a rifle? It's just stupid. Let's move on. Also, I'm going to go on an absolute rant again with this point. I absolutely despise the analogy, that this gun is better than this gun. I absolutely hate that. In Fortnite, you'll have your assault rifle, your SMG, and your shotgun, right? But then you'll have the common rarity, and if you have a common assault rifle on you, you see a green one or a blue one or legend, I don't care what rarity, you're going to pick it up if it's a higher, you're going to pick it up if it's a higher rarity, no matter what, because it's just better. It is literally better in stats. Not better by preference, not better by, like, you know, if you can use it, if it takes skill to use that weapon. It's the exact same weapon, just better. Now, again, PUBG, I use what I have. I use what I can all the time. In this, I use the better rarity gun. It's just what you do. And also the ammo types. Ammo types, it's just, like in PUBG, you know, I keep referencing PUBG. You know, if you have an AKM, that's pretty decked out. But you find that M4, on the ground, you're like, whew, do I take that or do I not? Because I have quite a bit of 7.62 here. But I don't have much 5.56. But I do prefer the M4, you know. It's a nice rifle. But, that AK, I have so much ammo for that AK. Fortnite, throw it all out the window. Medium ammo, take the other better gun. You know? That, like, man. Even Apex, to an extent, falls into this category. You got, like, what, 5 ammo types? You got your light, your heavy, your shotgun, your energy, and your sniper. And that's it. You look at the ammo types in PUBG and how scarce they are, how much variety they have, how much different they are from each other, what guns take each ammo type. It just makes sense. They use real life guns, real life ammo, and it just makes sense. This game, oh, light ammo, shove it into your SMG and pistol. Oh, 12 gauge, shove it into each and every shotgun on the map. You know, medium ammo, whatever the heck the caliber that would be, shove it into your AK, shove it into your burst assault rifle, shove it into your regular assault rifle. It just works, you know? Dumb. I don't like that. You know, the thing about rushing in Fortnite, this is going to come up a lot. Shotguns and submachine guns are optimal. Very optimal. Not optional. I thought I said optional. Optimal. Like, you're going to use a SMG or shotgun. You're going to be in a lot of close range engagements. It's just how people like to play. But with the lack of inventory space, you're either going to choose an SMG or a shotgun, right? Oh, it's what my playstyle. I kind of like the shotgun more than the SMG. But most of the time, you're going to throw that out the window, because every time, you're just going to use 3 slots. One for your assault rifle, necessity. One for your SMG, like pretty necessary. One for your shotgun. Every single stinking time, I find myself using assault rifle, SMG, and shotgun. There's no other loadout. And because of rushing, the shotgun and the SMG are almost like just as important as an assault rifle in this game. It's just how it's structured. Literally everyone will have a close range weapon. Suppressed weapons, like silenced weapons, they just make no difference in playstyle. It's not like you're gonna go stealthing around with your, suppressed SMG or suppressed sniper rifle. You're gonna pick off people without them knowing. It just doesn't work that way in this game. Also, Warzone. Warzone also falls into this trap. Ammo is way too plentiful. You will almost never have to change playstyle for low ammo engagements. If you're being attacked by a lot of squads, like, you know, you gotta get ammo, right? You're a little low on ammo. Once you kill somebody, you just run straight through all their loot, and boom, you're replenished on your ammo. In PUBG, if the person you're fighting doesn't have the same ammo type as you, and you're about to get engaged by another squad, that's not good. You're going to have to, you know, switch your other gun, switch your secondary, but in that game, you have it all depends in that game. Like, man, I should play PUBG a bit more often. Shields should be a rare thing, kind of. maybe rarities like Apex kind of has with their body shields. That's an idea I had, but it wouldn't really fit with Apex. It wouldn't really fit with Fortnite's pacing. I get it. You know, you don't want your like shields and everything just having different shields. It'd just be weird to the players. They should, in my opinion, with Fortnite, they should make it so that shields are like a rare blessing. You might get shields in your game. There's maybe like a 50-50 chance that you get it. It's kind of like, you know, level 3 body armor in PUBG. Oh, how many times am I going to reference PUBG in this video? Where level 3 armor, it's not like, oh, I'll get that eventually. It's maybe I'll be able to get that if I'm lucky. If I loot hard enough, if I search hard enough, maybe I'll find that level 3. Maybe if I sacrifice a bit more time outside the circle, I can find that level 3 armor. And this is just, oh, find some minis, find a pot shield or the regular shield potions, and then just drink them, you know? Almost everybody you fight that isn't, like, if you're not third-partying them, will probably have shields. And also for medical supplies, bandages, you know, they're not that great. You know, they only go up to 75. So all people are going to carry is a med kit. They're not going to sacrifice an entire slot to take both bandages and a med kit if they don't need to. They're just going to take a med kit with the now present. Like, the new age of Fortnite, you're just always going to carry a med kit. There's no point in anything else. Chug splashes barely heal anything, you know. You know, bandages only go up to 75. You're just going to take a med kit. Also, materials for building, very, very plentiful. You just, you know, dice up a couple smaller objects in a house, you dice up a tree, you know, you're just going to use wood anyway, but it's just still very plentiful. Like, I hardly find any times, like, in the modern Fortnite, that I'm low on mats, if I've at least tried a little bit to get mats. Only at the very, very beginning, I might be low on mats, but that doesn't matter. It makes sense. Like, it doesn't take that long to get enough mats. Now, as our Fortnite analysis comes to a close, microtransactions. Alright, you know, they say everything in the store is cosmetic, which is true, basically. Like, there's some emotes that you can kind of exploit. You can get a lower profile with some emotes. But, you know, that's just bound to happen, right? Maybe you can dodge a few sniper shots if you break dance on the floor. So what, right? It's just optional. I mean, you see TF2, there's literal emotes where you can kill people with the emotes. That just kind of fits with that game, though, you know? Fortnite, it's all about, like, it's so competitive all the time. It just doesn't support casual playstyle. If you're not good at the game, get out. That's the kind of analogy that they have. Now, V-Bucks, in my opinion, are still... Okay. So, V-Bucks are still, in my opinion, pretty expensive. Alright. And they're also... it's rarely that you'll get enough to buy something. For... Like, if you don't... Okay. Basically, most people are just gonna grind out in the Battle Pass, get just a few hundred V-Bucks every season. You know, for the free players, it's just not good. You know? And so they're like, oh, well, if you want to, it's optional, but if you want to buy V-Bucks to do it, you know, you can, right? I the only reason I have V-Bucks is because I bought Save the World, Fortnite Save the World, and I got a lot of V-Bucks from challenges, and I actually kind of enjoyed playing Save the World. I like it, it's how Fortnite was intended, and, you know, I enjoy it, right? It's a nice tower defense kind of thing. And I got rewarded in Battle Royale from doing the challenges in Save the World. Which is great because people want to buy Save the World. It's a good selling point. People want to buy it because they want skins in Battle Royale. It's great. And you can also use your skins in Save the World if you're a Save the World player, right? But now, they're just scammy. Like a long time ago now. I don't remember when. I don't know the exact date. They just removed V-Buck challenges, and also for your collection book, which actually takes a lot of effort and strategy to get those V-Bucks, and it takes a long time to level up. It takes a bit of grinding, it takes a bit to get some schematics, to get everything in your collection book, to get that couple hundred V-Bucks. Guess what? They threw it all out the window. It's a good selling point. People from Battle Royale will want to purchase Save the World, which already costs a bit of money, might want to buy a couple llamas with their V-Bucks, which will also cost money, and then they, you know, keep doing the challenges. Get more and more V-Bucks. Make a profit out of all this stuff. It's such a good thing. And then they just threw it all out the window because they support their Battle Royale players and they don't want people. They don't want people to, you know, buy Save the World and not have to buy V-Bucks. They don't want that. I don't know why they wouldn't. It's really cool. It's a nice alternative. And they just throw it out the window, you know. It's just scummy, really. So anyway, I know my other two Fortnite videos were not really that great. It was just me doing it completely unscripted, and I'm like, you know what? I wanna revisit in 2020. I wanna actually kind of give it a chance. One thing I will say about Fortnite, it's pretty fun. It's fun with friends. The only time I really ever play the game outside of this gameplay is just when I'm split screening with my brother every now and then. Like every blue moon, we'll just be like, oh, you want to split screen this game, you know, because you can't split screen Warzone, you know. Fortnite is great, it's fun, but that's it. In my opinion, that's all it has. It's kind of fun, just a super aggressive gameplay, you know, but still, that's only probably because I'm decent at the game. Some people that are more casual, you know, won't be too familiar with the game. It's free, so, you know, almost everybody is familiar with it at this point. But just, if you don't have the right skill level, get out. Because in 2020, sweats are everywhere because of this Marvel season. So yeah, that's it. I hope you all enjoyed. If you have any, like, counter-arguments or if you're trying to defend Fortnite, like, I'm genuinely giving it a chance. I'm not as childish and ignorant as I was in the other two videos. I was just a full PUBG person. Now, I'm open. I'm open to it, alright? If you just don't be like my friend I know in real life who was in the last video, who was just like, oh, you know, the guns are like Call of Duty or whatever. I forgot what he was saying, but do genuine arguments. Like, anytime you hear something that I said in the video that I didn't clarify or make, you know, my own kind of counter argument, just put in the comments, because I'll actually read them, because I'm not big. I'm not a big channel. I'll see your comment, and I'll take it into consideration as long as it's not blatantly stupid or irrelevant, and I might take it into consideration. Maybe I'll change about Fortnite. Maybe I'll see it how other people do. So, yeah. See you guys in the next video, and Zealot out. Man, this music's good.